Hello and a very warm welcome to a brand new edition of To The Point with me, Frank Pereira, on Rajya Sabha Television. The BJP is riding high after the recent successes in the recently held assembly polls in four states and one union territory. The BJP has now shifted focus to Uttar Pradesh, a state that it did wonderfully well in 2014, and it hopes to replicate that performance in 2017 as well, when the assembly polls will be held in that state. Joining me on the program today to talk about this and talk about several other things is the General Secretary, the National General Secretary of the BJP, Mr. Muralidhar Rao. Mr. Rao, thank you so much for joining me on the program. Firstly, congratulations on the fine performance in Assam and, you know, in Kerala as well. You did wonderfully well in the recently held assembly elections. Before we talk about that, let's look forward now and talk about Uttar Pradesh, because Uttar Pradesh has been in the news over the last 1 week or so. It's nice to see that the party is already looking ahead.
And definitely, after this five state elections where BJP has been historically weak, it has never been the stronghold of the BJP, these states. So after this performance, definitely the intent of BJP as a party, and also the president declaration after he became the president, that BJP will be going for the expansion mode, and it will be focusing on the east and south. So in the very first 2 years, to a large extent, we have been able to register that success both in the east and also in the south. So now people are also slowly realizing and accepting that BJP is replacing Congress as a national party in this country.
But wasn't that already done in 2014?
No, in terms of parliament elections, particularly in the context of UPA's misgovernance or bad governance and the kind of leadership which it had, people might have thought, this is only one election and a national election, and in a context BJP had won. But now this kind of results and this kind of expansion and this kind of increase in vote share, now people, even our adversaries, are accepting that BJP is becoming a relevant party and a player in almost all states of this country.
Let's talk about Assam now. You did wonderfully well in Assam, and many pre-poll, opinion polls as well as several polls suggested that the BJP would win comfortably. Now the Congress has dismissed it, saying that it's anti-incumbency and it was gifted on a platter to the BJP. The BJP did not do anything in Assam.
Even after BJP gaining the position by replacing Congress, people may say Congress has given a platter to BJP, that BJP has not worked hard to replace Congress. That can be a kind of view. But for the last so many years in Assam, BJP has been working very hard to fight for the identity issue of Assam and Assamese, and also the security concerns of the Assam people. And due to our agitation and our mobilization was not confined to Assam in the case of Assam. We mobilized even the people all over the country on the Assam issue. So now slowly in Assam, where different ethnic groups are there and different religious communities are there, all of them have accepted in terms of governance and in terms of development and in terms of Assam long-term interests, interests of protecting the ethnic identity and the interests of ethnic diversity. So BJP is well suited. So now people have accepted. Definitely is a test for us to show the same kind of skills and commitment which we have shown in other states.
BJP is accused of poaching leaders from other parties. One of them, of course, in Assam was Himanta Biswa Sarma. And could the BJP have done so well without Himanta Biswa Sarma in your pocket?
You know, one should not think in this way when a person comes and joins. You know, a person would not have joined BJP if BJP was not on that level, at threshold level, capable of capturing the people's imagination in Assam without which these people, whether it is Hemanto or anybody else, would not have accepted BJP as a viable alternative. So, BJP, we have not shown this kind of attitude only for the first time and only in the case of Assam. We have done in other places also. And when in our onward march, people realize, and leaders also in different parties, when they realize that BJP is the party which works for the development, and its concept of nationalism and its concept of one nation, one people, when they understand really, they see, they accept, they join.
You know,
so that's what happened in Assam.
He has changed color once already. Is that something that worries you maybe in the future if you do not give him what he wants?
No, I don't think so. Never we bargain with the leaders who join BJP, either with the posts or any kind of other allurements or attractions. You know, it's based on completely leadership of Modi ji and the central government's direction, and how it has promised and how it has worked in the last few years to give a positive hope for leaders and for people. So it is in one direction. We should not say only leader has made up his mind and people were not in that direction. So it's the same similar direction. And in Assam, because of our approach and our hard work, and also this Congress politics. Congress, when I say politics, is corruption and bad governance, all these things. So that made people to choose BJP.
Indeed. Okay, let's shift focus now and talk about the neighboring state of West Bengal, where polls were recently held as well. Were you happy with how things worked out in West Bengal? Because the BJP was hoping to do really well this time in West Bengal. We sent all your union leaders there to campaign, and even the Prime Minister was there to campaign as well. So hoping for some kind of a, you know, turnaround in West Bengal. Clearly, you must not be happy with what happened there.
You know, BJP has always, now if you see in the last 2 years, starting with the parliament elections and after that assembly elections, whether we have won or we have not been able to do that kind of thing. In all places, we have fought elections very seriously. Hmm. And pre-election preparation, or during the elections, and even after the elections, our work has been consistent, particularly under the leadership of Narendra Modi ji and under the leadership of Amit Shah as president. We have taken elections very seriously and we have worked very hard. And Bengal, definitely for the BJP, it is a long-term battle. Hmm. And we have done well. We could have done, more than this. But coming together of Congress and Communists, you know, they might not have succeeded in forming the government, but they have succeeded in stalling the BJP's, a kind of forward push this time.
Hmm.
So we had to satisfy ourselves at that percentage, 10% and all. But definitely in coming days, as an opposition to the Trinamool Congress government and any lapses or any omissions or any commissions, BJP is the only party which in Bengal is now positioned to fight the battle in a fierce way or in aggressive way. So definitely we see our future is bright in Bengal, and BJP will become a major player and capable of emerging as an alternative to the present leadership of Bengal.
When all else fails, go to Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Is Prime Minister Narendra Modi still your trump card?
It is an advantage. Ultimately, he is a leader of the party, and he is a governing face of the party and the nation. And we are proud of having him as a leader who is capable of creating hope, not only in India, even the Indians abroad. And even the people who feel and who watch India, they feel that he is a leader who has come to fulfill the aspirations of the people of this country. So this is we feel as an advantage for the party, and it is, we are utilizing and for our expansion and for our I can call it as he is a person who is safe landing our party in the uncharted areas.
You know, there is also a problem to that. There is the risk of overexposure. Is that something that worries you?
No. We are not neglecting when we are projecting Narendra Modi ji as a leader, as a prime minister, and as a number one leader of the party and alliance. We are equally focusing now on the local leadership and local issues, and we are not allowing the issues becoming secondary in any state, whether it is Kerala or it is Bengal or Assam, anywhere. If you see, we have never allowed our regional leadership getting neglected or like that.
Indeed. Interesting that you brought up Kerala. So let's shift further south now and talk about Kerala first, and then talk about Tamil Nadu, a state where you were in charge of the polls there. Kerala first, 14% vote share. Happy with that? Happy with what happened in Kerala? But unfortunately, it didn't translate to too many seats for you. It was just one seat.
No, because of this polarization and also the kind of consolidation which has taken place there, we could not convert our vote share into as many seats as we wanted. But definitely this vote share has created a kind of feeling that now BJP has become a player permanent in Kerala politics, and no more it is a marginal player. And this vote share has increased progressively. If you see parliament elections and then local body elections,
yes,
and now the state elections. So the state leadership, even at the constituency level, or even at the local body level, or even at the state level, now our leadership is gaining acceptance among the people of Kerala. And no more people can say that BJP has no leader with face. So that kind of situation is now slowly going down. And definitely the central government and Narendra Modi ji's leadership and our national perspective are now finding more space and more friends in Kerala. So by the time we go for the parliament elections in Kerala next time, and then again when you see the next assembly elections, definitely BJP will be the main opposition player for this present left government. Because BJP is the only party which is capable of fighting on ideological front, whether it is economic policies or the policies related to development or all other things, cultural front. So BJP is the right party to oppose this left front there.
In other words, you're saying, you're heading towards Congress Mukt Bharat, a slogan that you've been, talking about for a while now.
Yeah, now it is reaching a kind of logical conclusion slowly. India is moving towards that. You know, after defeating Congress in Delhi elections, now slowly people, wherever Congress is, I put two categories of one: Congress where it is Congress ruling, and where Congress is not ruling. In both the places, Congress slowly it is going down, and a kind of tail party for the other main parties. So its significance and its space is slowly shrinking.
But then the BJP has been accused of, indulging in some hanky-panky work as well, as far as Uttarakhand is concerned or Arunachal Pradesh is concerned. For a party of your stature, should this be linked to the BJP?
It is completely a misinformation campaign. It is not that BJP is involved in any kind of horse trading or any kind of sabotaging or destabilizing the government. It's not that. In Uttarakhand, if you take, they have failed completely. And on the money bill, if you don't go for the, when they sought for the division, the speaker has not allowed. You have utilized the position of speaker and wanted to sabotage the whole democratic system. So that's what central government went for. It is not correct, and the way CDs and all others have come, so it is not other way round. I call it is completely Congress mismanagement and its internal problems, and its inability to keep the party in a cohesive way. That created a kind of instability in Uttarakhand. It is not BJP which has taken lead and created the division.
Couldn't you have just waited for one more year, because the Congress was imploding in Arunachal, in Uttarakhand any which ways? So if you'd have waited for another one more year, things would have gone smoothly for the BJP.
It's not a question of strategy of the party. That whether BJP will gain by waiting for 6 months or 8 months, it is not the issue related to strategy. Or it is not really issue related to some kind of tactical position. It was an issue related to a principle. You know, the government which has lost the majority and which could not win on the occasion of money bill, how it can continue? How it can hoodwink the whole thing and can continue? So this was the principle on which central government has taken a decision. It was a matter of principle. It was nothing to do with the BJP's gain and politically or BJP losing something like this. Never we thought in that way.
Okay, let's move on now and talk about Tamil Nadu, because that was a state that you were in charge of. In 2014, the BJP managed to cobble up an alliance and do very well in Tamil Nadu. In 2016, 2 years later, somehow everything went awry for the BJP. It could not cobble up a strong alliance. And thus, it resulted in what happened in the assembly elections.
Now, Tamil Nadu is a very peculiar state. Tamil Nadu is a very big state and a huge population. And technology-wise, the state is very advanced and exposed to the all modern technologies and communication. And political awareness is also very high. When it came to Delhi elections, they thought Narendra Modi ji is very important in Delhi and he should be there. And they voted for our alliance. And we could also create the alliance because of that advantage. You know, that advantage made, all these parties to come together and accept the BJP leadership. So that was the situation. Now, coming to the state elections, there is, if you take the network and party system and all, it's an intense polarization between DMK and ADMK. And both parties fighting each other. In that situation, people thought that, BJP, still it has not reached that kind of position. So its ability to play a major role in Tamil Nadu, they thought it is not possible.
But why couldn't you keep the allies of 2014
Because of this situation only. There are two important issues we have to understand for the failure of BJP to keep the old alliance intact. One is regional elections and national elections, all players, they thought it's a different, and in the regional elections, people will be taking a different line. So partners who stood with us, they thought we should go in other direction. And second important thing, there were contradictions also. Some kind of conflicting interest was also there. DMDK leadership, they wanted that their candidate should become the chief minister candidate. And PMK leader also felt that their candidate must be the chief minister candidate. So both had the conflicting targets. So because of that, they went in different directions and we could not keep them together. So that was the issue. And there was another, another disadvantage for us also. You know, when it comes to center, AIDMK government, on the government on certain issues, they supported BJP government, NDA government. So the relation between AIDMK and BJP are not like adverse parties. So BJP is seen as a friendly party of AIDMK. So when they thought AIDMK may lose, many of our supporters, they thought that no, DMK should not win because DMK and Congress are together and they are opposed to BJP and NDA here. So the fight is not between BJP and DMK. The fight is not between BJP, DMK and Congress Alliance to choose BJP. So the fight was between AIDMK and DMK Congress Alliance. So many of our own supporters and voters, they thought no, Congress should not gain or DMK should not gain. So that was the reason, you know, even exit polls and many other surveys, they went wrong.
Very interesting analysis, and you've had time to look back and analyze these things also because it's been 2 weeks since the results were announced. Let's look ahead now and look to the future. Some crucial states going to polls in 2017, very crucial for the BJP also because that shores up your numbers in the Rajya Sabha where you're still in a minority. Uttar Pradesh being the first state, of course, so because, you know, many poll analysts in the past too have said that the road to Delhi is through Uttar Pradesh. Do you agree with that? Do you think that Uttar Pradesh is very, very important for the BJP?
Here, I will, before going for this Uttar Pradesh issue, I will take up, this Rajya Sabha issue, the numbers in Rajya Sabha. Now, after these elections, all over the country, the regional parties also have realized Congress is not a party which can relied upon or which can be depended. And people are not choosing Congress and people are slowly deserting Congress all over the country. So the parties which are interested in playing a role in their own states, I don't think they will be working in tandem with Congress in order to oppose the bills or other issues in Rajya Sabha. So I see, regional parties and their leadership taking a mature view of the Delhi situation and also the political management and governance issues. Definitely, they will take a different line when it comes to the bills which are important for the development.
So you're saying you're going to get support now from some of the regional parties to push some crucial bills like the GST, which has been hanging limbo for a while now.
I feel so. I feel so. It will be very difficult for the Congress and the left parties to keep all regional parties with them and oppose BJP and NDA. I don't think this is going to happen, and that too after this kind of elections and this kind of results, people are realizing now. Going with Congress means you are also going down, accepting to go in that direction. So nobody is going to sink with Congress.
Okay.
So this will change the picture in coming days in Delhi and that particularly in the parliament.
And now to Uttar Pradesh.
Uttar Pradesh is a very important state, and BJP has won, a kind of record number of seats in Uttar Pradesh. So the way we have won in 7 seats in Assam and now we have formed the government. In the same way in Uttar Pradesh, the number of seats we have won for the parliament, the leadership which it has created, it will work to the advantage of UP. And our national president, Amit Shah ji, has created a plan, and we have already started our work in Uttar Pradesh. Definitely, Uttar Pradesh development.
What is this plan? Do you want to elaborate on the plan?
No, plan of both. One is the political issues which are going to be important for the BJP in Uttar Pradesh. That we have already started, and number of meetings and other programs are taking place. So organization getting mobilized and getting energized and activated to take these elections in Uttar Pradesh. This we are doing it. And second, in coming days, reach out and taking the issues in of Uttar Pradesh. This will also, we will work on those things very seriously. Definitely, we will play a role, and automatically in Uttar Pradesh, BJP will be seen as a party which can govern to provide development.
Indeed. You know, One final question before I let you go. As far as Uttar Pradesh is concerned, we saw in Bihar, we saw in Haryana, the BJP did not go with a chief ministerial face, but in Delhi the strategy was different. You had a chief ministerial face for Delhi. What's going to happen in Uttar Pradesh?
It's an interesting thing. How a party is going to face the elections with the leader declared or without leader declared? This is the question which is now a kind of creating anxious movements in within the party and outside party. What will be the decision of the parliamentary board of the party, and how Narendra Modi ji and Amit Shah ji and all our top leadership will sit, and what kind of decision they will take. But it is too early now. Definitely after our national executive meeting, which is going to be held in Allahabad, and after the first round of programs, then definitely taking the inputs gathered from all parts of the state, then what would be the better strategy or best strategy, and based on that we will our top leadership will take the decision.
We are out of time on the program, but one final question I'd like to slip in before we close the show. As far as Uttar Pradesh is concerned, who do you believe is your biggest opponent?
Amit Shah has already declared, and based on our internal discussions and all, in a polity like what we have in India and what we have in Uttar Pradesh, the subject of scrutiny for the people will be Samajwadi Party.
Okay. All right, Mr. Muralidhar Rao, thank you so much for joining us on the program and putting things into perspective for us. That's all the time we have on this edition of To The Point. Thank you so much for watching. See you again next time.